Hey everyone, I'm Katie and this is South Island Kitchen. I have a whole bunch of my favorite recipes that I want to share with you, so I hope you'll stick around. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Katie and this is Sherlock, but he does not want to be on camera. So, thanks a lot, Sherlock. Anyway, we're gonna do some ribs today. I'm gonna show you a little experiment that I'm gonna try. I have no idea if this is gonna be good, but the good news is I do something similar to this to my Christmas ham, and it's very good and everybody loves it. So I thought, well, since the ribs are pork and the ham is pork, maybe this sauce that I'm used to doing on my ham will also taste good on the ribs. So it's a total experiment. We're gonna try it out. Hopefully it's good. If you're seeing this video, then it was good because I'm not gonna post a recipe that I think is yucky. So anyway, I'm gonna get started.
You should have just heard the belch that my dog just did. Oh my gosh, Moose. Anyway, I'm gonna season these ribs with some pepper. Oh, also I should say that I put a little bit of water in the bottom of my little roasting pan here because that's what I always do with my ham. So I put a little bit of water. I'm also gonna season this with the Auntie Nono's Everything seasoning. If you don't have this, you can order it online or you can use garlic salt. This has sea salt, garlic, onion, and spices in it. So it's a good mixture of spices. I'm gonna go ahead and shake this on. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna cover this with foil and I'm gonna bake this at 350 for, oh boy, whatever the package said. I think it said 1.5 to 2 hours. So I'm gonna do that. And then during like the last 15 minutes or so of cooking, I'm going to pour a sauce over it that I'm going to make. And it's just a spicy brown mustard and brown sugar sauce. So we're gonna pour that over in the last like 15 minutes of baking. So I'm gonna get these wrapped in foil and get these into the oven.
Are you being camera shy, Mr. Sherlock? Look at you, every time I bring the camera around. Oh, hi, Watson. Do you wanna be on camera today? So if brother doesn't wanna be on camera, I'll be on camera, because look at how cute I am. I'm so cute. My name is Watson. Oh, and there's Chloe. Hi, pretty girl. You wanna be on camera too? I'm such a pretty girl.
There's Mr. Sherlock.
You're being so shy, mister. You're being so shy.
Sherlock. Hey, Mr. Swishy Tail.
Sherlock. There's my pretty boy.
So I know in the summertime, we don't always want to turn on our ovens and heat up the house, especially for 2 hours to cook ribs. But you don't have to do it that way if you don't want. You can grill them on the barbecue and then put them in the crock pot and let them cook slowly during the day and then it won't heat up your house as much. You can definitely do that. I was out today and I didn't remember to put the ribs in the crock pot before I left. So I'm gonna just do it in the oven and it'll be ready by dinner time. And it's not really that hot today. It didn't even get into the 70s. So I'm not too worried about the house overheating. But anyway, just wanted to let you know. I've got my little saucepan set to medium high. And I'm gonna go ahead and put together our spicy brown mustard and brown sugar sauce because the ribs have been in the oven for about 1.5 hours. And I wanna get this sauce on them and like let them cook for, you know, another 15 to 30 minutes in the oven with the sauce on there. We're gonna do like about 1/2 cup of spicy brown mustard. Let's get this out of here. And then we're gonna do about 1/2 cup of brown sugar. There we go. Okay, now we're gonna whisk those together. I'm gonna pour some of this sauce over the ribs and then just kind of brush it on. I did use a ladle and I got out some of this water from the bottom of the pan because there was quite a bit and I poured it down the sink, but I did leave a little bit because I don't want my brown sugar to burn to the bottom of my pan, so.
Okay, and then just for good measure, I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle a little bit more brown sugar on top. Just because I like my ribs really sweet and I wanna make sure, because this is an experiment, I've never done this before and I don't want it to taste too mustardy, even though we do really like spicy brown mustard. I definitely want it to be sweet, so hopefully by adding a little extra brown sugar on top, it'll be just right. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna cover this back up with foil and I'm gonna continue it in the oven for another 15 to 30 minutes. I need a side dish to go with my ribs, so I'm gonna make some cheesy broccoli orzo pasta. So in my big saucepan here, I have it heating to medium high, and I have a big glass measuring cup here that's 4 cups, but I put 2 cups of chicken broth in here and 1 cup of milk. So I have 3 cups of liquid all together. I'm gonna pour that in my saucepan. And I'm gonna put a lid on that and let it come to a gentle boil. And once it's boiling, I'm gonna add in my 1.5 cups of orzo pasta and my 1 cup of broccoli. Okay, this came to a boil underneath my lid. So I'm gonna put 1.5 cups of orzo pasta in and 1 cup of broccoli. And I'm gonna let that come back up to a simmer. And then we'll add in our cheese and our seasonings. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and add some salt. Gonna stir that around a little bit. Add a little bit more. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add in 1/4 cup of Parmesan cheese. Give that a stir. And then I'm gonna go ahead, I'm not really gonna measure, I'm just gonna grate in some cheddar cheese. Maybe about 1/4 cup to 1/2 cup of cheddar cheese. The second recipe I want to share with you this week is based on the answers I got from my family and friends on Facebook when I asked them what they like to eat for dinner in the summer. And a bunch of them said grilled meat, and they also said salads. So tonight we're going to have a marinated grilled chicken, and we're going to put it on one of my favorite salads. So I have a large chicken breast here that I cut in half and defrosted, and a little one here that I had in the freezer and I defrosted as well. Of course, it started to cook on the edges because it's a lot smaller than these two, but that's okay. We're gonna throw those in a baggie with all the marinade ingredients on the back of the package for 15 minutes. And we're gonna wash, chop, and spin our romaine lettuce here. I've got a green bell pepper, some corn that we're gonna toast in the pan, some pesto and ranch, salami and mozzarella, and then I was gonna do feta because I usually do on this particular salad that I'm making, but the grocery store that I went to, it was just unreasonable, the price. Let's just put it that way. It was a ridiculous price for the container of feta. So I'm like, you know what? I can go without feta tonight. I'm not gonna pay that price. So anyway, let's get going on this salad because we are all really hungry and ready for dinner. I have my zesty herb marinade mix in this bag here. I just did the package instructions, oil, water, vinegar. But I'm going to reserve some aside in this bowl to baste the chicken with. So I'm gonna set that aside and then I'm gonna marinate the chicken in what's left. We'll just set this in the fridge and let that marinate while I cut up the lettuce and the green bell pepper and chop up the salami. I have my little basket of romaine cut up here and washed, ready to go.
And then I quartered up some little pieces of salami. I've got maybe about a half a cup here. It's really just personal, you know, preference, however much salami you want. And then I have one green bell pepper that I washed and diced into little pieces. So I've got that all ready. Now I'm gonna go out and grill the chicken.
I have the grill heating at about 350 and I've got my chicken on there. And then over here I've got my corn. I just did one can of corn drained and I added some olive oil. So we're gonna heat this up like medium high and get that corn browning so we can have some toasted corn. Are you excited that mommy's outside grilling? Yes. Are you excited that mama's outside grilling? She's like, come on, where's the handouts, lady? Where's the handouts? There's nothing in your hand. There's nothing in your hand. Oh, moose. Okay, this corn is done. I'm just gonna sprinkle a little bit of salt on there. It doesn't need a lot. But you just want it to look toasty. With those little brown marks on it. Okay, let's put our salad together. So I'm gonna just take a handful of my romaine and put it in my bowl here. I'm gonna add our chicken. And then we're gonna throw some salami on there. Green bell peppers. Get some of this yummy toasted corn on there. It's such a pretty salad, it's so colorful. Okay, I'm gonna also shake on a little pepper, a little bit of mozzarella cheese. Normally I would do the feta, but like I said earlier, I didn't end up buying any. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and put my ranch dressing on top. This is obviously however much you want, personal choice, personal preference. You can do homemade ranch or store-bought ranch. And then the best part, adding in a little spoonful of this pesto with basil. This is what really takes it over the edge. I love to mix this pesto with the ranch dressing. So good. Kind of reminds me of that dressing at the Old Spaghetti Factory, that pesto ranch. Oh man, so good. Moose, we're having salad for dinner. And you can't have chicken, buddy. You want a little piece of salami? Was that good?